My name is Professor Betty Lisa Anderson, and I'm a professor here in the Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering. My dad is an electrical engineer, and so when I was a kid growing up, he got me interested in that. But since I became an electrical engineer, I find it's really fun because you get to invent stuff, and you get to learn all these cool things, and when new technology happens, you're the first one to understand it, or you could be the one to invent it. So it's lots of fun. I like going in the lab and building things and making things and inventing stuff. Ooh, I do all kinds of fun things. Everything to do with light was just so cool because you can see what you're doing, except for when they make me work in the infrared, then I don't get to see what I'm doing. So we use light to solve engineering problems, and one of the things that we work on is using MEMS, which are microelectromechanical systems. They're chips. They're actually chips with little tiny moving parts on them that can operate mechanically, like mirrors in my case. So when you apply electrostatic voltage, you can make the mirrors tip one way or the other. And then I bounce light beams back and forth between a bunch of mirrors like I have over here. And the idea is you bounce it back and forth, and every time they bounce, they hit a MEMS mirror, and then you tip the mirror one way or the other, and you switch the beam and do marvelous things. One of the things that we work on is using these light beams to steer a phased array antenna. So if you don't know what a phased array antenna is, that's okay, because we have classes you can take. But it's a big giant array of antennas, and when you add them all up, so that they're, all their beams, which are very wide individually, when they add them up, they're all very directional. So when you go to the airport and you see that antenna that's spinning around and around to scan the sky, you don't want to do that mechanically. You don't want to have to grease the bearings, so you want to do that electrically. So we take the electrical signals that are going to the antenna elements, each antenna element, and we put them on light beams, and then we bounce the light beams back and forth to create time delays, and then the time delays change when the RF signal comes out of the antennas, each antenna in the array, and it effectively steers the beam. So you can take that beam and steer it around the sky without having to move any parts. Oh, that's very cool. The ECE department, I like it here. I'm very happy here because all the people are nice. And you think, oh, it's a big, giant school. No one's going to remember my name. It doesn't feel like that at all. It feels really intimate. You know all the people around, and they're friendly. Maybe it's the Midwest. I don't know. But people are just plain nice. So I like it here a lot. When you come to Ohio State, the first thing you do is you go to the freshman program, and all the engineers take the same freshman courses, and they're really good. In fact, I'm insanely jealous. I wish I'd had that when I was young, but no, we had rocks and bricks and stuff. But anyways, it's a very good freshman program, and what they do is they have all these labs, and so each lab, one lab, it might be electrical lab, the next lab might be a mechanical lab, the next lab might be chemical engineering lab. So during that freshman year, you have lots of time to explore all the different things you want to do and see what floats your boat, and then you'll come to your senses and come to electrical engineering. Once you get into electrical engineering, we just scrapped our entire sophomore program. We had these older courses that had been around a while, and we just threw those out, and we took them, and we made this new sophomore sequence that is so cool. Oh, it is very cool. So they have iPads in the lab, and they have all these cool equipment. Very all brand new equipment, I might say. They got this special room that only sophomores can go in. Can I go in there? No, my card key won't open it. Sophomores can go in there, and in addition to all the labs, which is an open lab, so they can go in anytime they want and work on their project, they also have a big screen TV so they can rewatch the lectures, and they can chat with each other, and on Friday nights they can watch movies, and they have a popcorn machine in there. I mean, this is not right. When I was young, did I mention rocks and bricks? So the sophomore program is really cool, and then once you get through that, then you've had sort of the basics, and then you start going out and taking all your technical electives, and we have like a bazillion technical electives. That's actually one of the advantages of coming to a big school like Ohio State, because we're so big, we have lots and lots of courses. You can take all kind of crazy stuff. You can take medical imaging, you can take the photonics lab, that's a good one, you can take lasers or fiber optics, you can take neural networks, communications, all kinds of things, wireless, antennas, all kind of stuff. How to prepare to be successful in ECE or in engineering in general, I would say, keep up with your math and science, and when you're studying for that final exam, study to remember it for life. Don't just study it to get through the exam. I wish I had done more of that, so there are a lot of things I had to go back and relearn that I should have known. I would have saved a lot of time, and I would have been better if I'd have learned all that stuff for real.